तो पहला हमें क्या चाहिए, कोई भी कायदा में प्रिलिमिनरी रहता है, व्हाट इज द एक्ट ऑल अबाउट एंड द डेफिनेशन, दिस इज द चैप्टर नंबर वन. इन एनी चैप्टर्स यू विल फाइंड दिस. सो वी हैव चैप्टर नंबर वन विच इज अ प्रिलिमिनरी चैप्टर. व्हाट इज रेरा? रेरा इज नथिंग बट रियल एस्टेट रेगुलेशन एंड डेवलपमेंट एक्ट 2016. सम पीपल कॉल इट एज रेरा बिकॉज आर ई, ओके, रियल एस्टेट आर डी ए. अदरवाइज वाई इट इज कॉल्ड रेरा इज because it is real estate regulation, it is real estate regulatory authority. So there is real estate regulatory authority to take care of real estate project. So second is, the whenever we are talking about regulation, it also talk, let us say SEBI. What is SEBI does? SEBI is regulating capital market. Similarly, if you are talking about insurance, it is insurance regulatory authority. Then we have, you know, banking regulation, which is that RBI. So that means we are always concentrating the business that has to be regulated. So which is the business we are talking about here? So the regulation has to be always related to business. Now what is the business here? Real estate. Now we have to understand in the real estate, what is that we'll be looking into. So chapter number two talks about, that is chapter number two. Chapter number two, this is chapter number one, preliminary, and this is effective from 1st May 2017 and across India. The second is about the business. What is the business that is going to be regulated? So the moment we talk about business, that is real estate business. Now in the real estate business, aap bataiye ki what is the specialty in real estate business? रियल एस्टेट बिजनेस में क्या होता है? बिजनेस रियल एस्टेट बिजनेस, रियल एस्टेट बिजनेस मीन्स वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट अ प्रोजेक्ट. आर यू गेटिंग माई पॉइंट? सो सपोज वेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट रेगुलेशन, लेट अस टॉक अबाउट आर बी आई इज रेगुलेटिंग बैंकिंग. तो बैंकिंग में आर बी आई क्या करती है? आर बी आई क्या करती है? आर बी आई एक लाइसेंस देती है, एक रजिस्ट्रेशन करती है, बराबर है कि नहीं? सिमिलरली इंश्योरेंस कंपनी जो है रजिस्टर्ड होती है, उसको लाइसेंस देता है इंश्योरेंस कंपनी. सेम वे हियर इज द रेगुलेटर. सो देयरफॉर इन द एनी रियल एस्टेट रेगुलेशन ऑल्सो वी हैव अ रेगुलेटर. सो द रेगुलेटर, हु इज द रेगुलेटर? एवरीथिंग इज गिवन इन चैप्टर नंबर फाइव. चैप्टर नंबर फाइव इट इज टॉकिंग अबाउट रियल एस्टेट रेगुलेटरी अथॉरिटी. Who is the real estate regulatory authority? What are the conditions? All this is given from section 20 to section 40. So we are talking about real estate regulatory authority. Now this authority, the way RBI is there, same way this authority consisting of three people is going to have one as a chairperson and two other members. They are going to regulate the real estate business. So in order to regulate the real estate business, रियल एस्टेट रेगुलेटरी अथॉरिटी के पास आपका प्रोजेक्ट को रजिस्ट्रेशन करना है. आर यू गेटिंग माई पॉइंट? सो देयरफॉर व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इज चैप्टर नंबर टू टॉक्स अबाउट रजिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ ए रियल एस्टेट प्रोजेक्ट. सो द रजिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ ए रियल एस्टेट प्रोजेक्ट, व्हाट इज रियल एस्टेट प्रोजेक्ट, व्हेन इट इज टू बी रजिस्टर्ड, एंड इफ यू डोंट रजिस्टर व्हाट हैपन्स, दैट इज गिवन इन द पेनल्टी. सो देयर इज चैप्टर नंबर सेवन, sorry, chapter number 8 is talking about penalty, offences and penalty. So if something is not done in the act what is required, naturally there has to be penalty. So the penalty starts from section 59 to 69. So there are 11 sections which is talking about different types of penalties. So in the real estate business, naturally real estate project has to be registered. What is project, how it is to be registered, with whom it is to be registered, within what time it is to be registered, and which are the projects which are exempted, hamesha hota hai. So that is all given in chapter number 2. Chapter number 3 is talking about, so this is real estate projects section 3 to section 8, because this we are talking about section 1 to 2, chapter number 1. Now real estate project, when we are marketing a real estate project, we also need the help of real estate agents. ध्यान में आ रहा है? तो इधर एजेंट्स को भी रजिस्टर कर रहा है, क्योंकि दे आर ऑल्सो पार्ट एंड पार्सल ऑफ द रियल एस्टेट बिजनेस. क्योंकि यदि एजेंट ने कोई गलत इन्फॉर्मेशन दिया तो गलत नहीं होना चाहिए. सो चैप्टर नंबर टू में रजिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ रियल एस्टेट प्रोजेक्ट एंड रजिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ रियल एस्टेट एजेंट, रियल एस्टेट एजेंट्स. सो दैट इज सेक्शन 9 and 10. सेक्शन 9 and 10 टॉक्स अबाउट व्हाट आर द वेरियस रियल एस्टेट एजेंट्स, व्हाट आर देयर ड्यूटीज, ये सब बात की. चैप्टर नंबर 3 इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड द एंटायर थिंग इज रिलेटेड टू चैप्टर नंबर 2 and 3. चैप्टर नंबर 3 इज नथिंग बट मेन, हु इज द मेन पर्सन हु डज द बिजनेस रियल एस्टेट में, कौन है, कौन बिजनेस कर रहा है? नेचुरली बिल्डर, दैट इज कॉल्ड प्रोमोटर. रियल एस्टेट रेगुलेशन एंड डेवलपमेंट एक्ट 2016 में द पर्सन हु डेवलप्स द रियल एस्टेट एंड मार्केट्स द रियल एस्टेट प्रोजेक्ट एंड हु डज द बिजनेस इज नोन एज प्रोमोटर. सो द ऑब्लिगेशंस और दैट इज कॉल्ड फंक्शंस एंड ड्यूटीज, फंक्शंस एंड ड्यूटीज ऑफ प्रमोटर. हु इज प्रमोटर? वन हु कंस्ट्रक्ट्स एंड सेल्स. सो नेचुरली दैट इज सेक्शन 11 to 18. सो दिस इज अनदर चैप्टर विच इज मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट एंड ड्रेकोनियन लॉ, दैट इज सेक्शन 11 to 18. पीपल आर मोर वरीड अबाउट सेक्शन 3 to 8 एंड 11 to 18. These are the two basic, you know, chapter that we have to talk about. And the next chapter is chapter number 4, is nothing but that is related to rights and duties, rights and duties of allottees, because that is the next allottees. So that means the next chapter we are talking about rights and duties of the allottees. Isme kitna sections hai? How many section? Only one section. So section 19 is talking about rights and duties of the allottees. Now we have discussed chapter number 5 also, section 20 to 40, that is related to RERA. What is RERA? Real Estate Regulatory Authority. How many people are there? What are their functions? What are their duties? In short, RERA ka kaam hai real estate project ko register karna, promoter ko regulate karna, to unka returns ले लेना ऑन क्वार्टरली बेसिस एंड देन गिव देम एनी डायरेक्शंस एंड इफ देर इज एनी थिंग रॉन्ग देन लेवी द पेनल्टी, रिकवर द पेनल्टी एंड इफ देर इज एनी कंप्लेंट हियर द कंप्लेंट्स ऑफ दी स्टेक होल्डर्स एंड नेचुरली टेक नेसेसरी एक्शन. द नेक्स्ट इज चैप्टर नंबर 6 इज रिलेटेड टू सेंट्रल एडवाइजरी काउंसिल. सेंट्रल एडवाइजरी काउंसिल, the way we have a GST council, what is the duty of a GST council? We know in order to recommend to the central government and state government to various aspects of GST, levy of rates, this, that, classification, barabar na, that is all. This council is again a statutory body that is under the constitution and this is under the act. Again, this is the act of parliament. So therefore, central advisory council, which consists of housing minister as the chairperson and thereafter of course nearly 5 people from the central government, another 5 people from different state governments, and then RERA authorities, like this 15 people from the government, and another 10 people from the various NGOs like builders, estate agents, maybe instead of chartered accountants, NGOs. So this way it is consisting of not less than 25 people committee, which will guide the state government and central government in order to regulate the sector, recommend certain changes in the act. So that is, we have advisory council. Then we have, you know, appellate tribunal. So the next is chapter number, see what happens is any authorities which is set up, what happens is naturally they require what is known as the appellate authority, because normally we know even in the income tax CIT appeal will be there, but we have income tax appellate tribunal. Same way we have an appellate authority which is known as real estate appellate tribunal. Now again, appellate tribunal, the chairman of the appellate tribunal is none other than the either Supreme Court judge or the High Court judge, who is the chairman of the Appellate Tribunal, and then one more, you know, judicial person, and one technical or administrative person. So this way, we have three people who are there in the Appellate Tribunal. Then, of course, as I said, offences, penalties, adjudication. So there is penalty, and thereafter, you know, there is in the same chapter number 8, the first part is related to penalty, and thereafter we have, this is 40, I think sections 41 and 42, and this is 43 to 58, and then this is 59 to 69, and then in the chapter number 8 also, there is something called adjudication, penalty, offences and adjudication. What do you mean by adjudication? Adjudication means assessment. Adjudication ka matlab hai assessment. So, the next chapter is related to adjudication and assessment. Assessment of what? Assessment of damages. Abhi kya hota hai ki, you know, assessment of damages. What happens is, in the any real estate, if the promoter has sold the flat unit and the customer has purchased, and if there is any defects in the construction, or if there is a delay in the delivery, or what has been promised as per the agreement or the as per the advertisement, it is not given. So that means there is something called, you know, damages. So which is given in section 71 and 72. And section 70 is related to recovery of the amount. So this way we have section 70, 71, 72 in chapter number 8. Then we have chapter number 9. Of course, that is nothing to do with us. Chapter number 9 is nothing but it is related to accounts audit of the regulatory authority. Because ultimately, regulatory authority is a, again, a separate corporate body consisting of three people. They are going to recover the money towards the registration fees, penalties, various things. And therefore, there has to be accounts, audit, everything, and filing of return. All this will be done with the government. And the last is, this is section 73 to 78. And last is, chapter number 10 is miscellaneous, which starts from 79 onwards up to 92. In the miscellaneous last chapter, it is talked about what is known as the RERA is like, you know, any disputes related to real estate has to be taken only to the real estate regulatory authority. You cannot go to the civil court. Even if you want to go to the criminal court, then it has to be through the real estate regulatory authority. Bar of civil court is there. And delegation of powers and having a overriding effect. So all the miscellaneous provisions are given in chapter number 10. So this way, aap dekhenge, section 92 tak hai. Section 1 to section 92 divided into 10 chapters. And it is only talking about real estate and registration of a real estate. And then registration of a real estate broker.